Recovery, solid spin recovery. Spinning on the left wing once, about 1 1/8 recovering, a 1 1/8 spin. All right, up and over the top we go in a Barnstormer's loop. And all these maneuvers, you will fly in the air show if you go for, or not in the air show, but in the airplane after the show. There we go, with a roll to the left. It's a snap roll. The best the sailman can do a snap roll, that is, where you're going to pull the stick all the way back in the left quadrant or the right quadrant. This is going to be a hammerhead stall. Now, each maneuver is entered at exactly the right speed for each airplane, unless you're in combat, and then you throw all the rules out the window. Again, another loop. Let's see if we make a figure eight out of this. Yes, it's in a roll. It's a Cuban eight, named after the instructor of the Cuban Air Force in 1934. That was Len Povey. He actually started out to do a loop with a snap on the top, and he had way too much speed, so he just came over the top and made a figure eight. And they said, "What is that?" I don't know. It's called an eight, a Cuban eight. So that was all the way back to 1934. And again, each airplane has its own parameters, its own speeds for entering the maneuver. And you're going to see the pit special work out a little while later with Charlie Schwenker and see a lot of different entering speeds for these very same maneuvers. You would learn these maneuvers in your basic training in World War II. Now we're going to roll the airplane to the left, a four-pointer, hanging it upside down. Spark is provided by magnetos, just like your lawnmower. A magneto. A magnet revolving through a coil of wire. Fuel is supplied by, again, a very similar carburetor to your lawnmower, a float bowl carburetor. So if you hang this type of airplane upside down, that engine, it does not have an inverted fuel and oil system. If you just hang it upside down, it'll temporarily run out of fuel. Then you have to roll it upright to get the fuel running back into the engine. Entering speed for the loop, maybe 120, 130, or the roll.
What a sailor, huh, folks?
No, that's nice. Isn't that nice? Now, I'm going to tell you, flying the steerman and doing aerobatics with that thing is not like a Jim Dye's A4, where you just push the stick to the left or the right, or the span. With the steerman, you've got to really, the stick has a life of its own. You're going to feel some serious pressure on the right arm and the left foot. You're going to have to use a lot of muscle. It's like working out on a Nautilus machine or something when you fly these things in aerobatics. It's physical. Quite physical.
And when it gets low, it gets very scaly.
Yes, because of the high density altitude,
which exactly.
Just means thin air because of the hot sun.
That's why flying suits come with two pairs of pants.
Two pairs of pants. Let's see if we're ready for a photo pass or just a landing, I think. Coming from the south. The south is to your left, the north is to the right. That's the way this runway is aligned. We have a little diagonal we can use in a serious crosswind situation. But this is a no-win situation. There's a picture taken pass. Dave Brown, Air Force Dave Brown. Give him a hand there, folks.
Just as smooth as he can be.
Absolutely smooth as glass. Now, Baron, we talked about the kids having a birthday in July.
Oh, yeah. That is correct. What we need to do is have the kids come up here in front.
Every kid
wants... All the ones who did not blow up their balloons, except, you know, like you.
All the children who would like a free piece of candy, please come up to the front.
Everybody's got to come up to the front, and the rest of the crowd's got to stand up. So come on, crowd, stand up. Stand up. Everybody got to stand up. Because what we're going to do here is, as you can see, I'm a Prussian on my father's side, but on my mother's side, she was a Viking kind of woman. She had a big braided hair like this. When she had, what else, what do you call it in English?
What?
Beard.
Your mother had a beard?
Yeah, a little bit like your mother had a beard. Yeah. But anyway, what we're going to do now is we're in Viking mode, and what we're going to do is a thing called the Viking birthday chant. That's why you got the balloons. So what you have to do is you'd have to take your balloon in your left hand and hold it out in front of you. Put your right fist over your chest. Come on, do it. Indulge me. Okay, you got your right fist over your chest. That means you too. Red shirt.
Dave is taxiing by. You can take a picture of him there.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead, Baron.
Okay, you got what you're going to help? You'll repeat after me. Smoldering smorgasbord. Another birthday already?
Another birthday already.